Now we're going to do language. We're doing page 89 today. And we are going to be learning about verb subject and verb agreement. Right? First thing we're going to do, though, is just find the subject and the verb in some sentences. So we're going to go back and do what we've been doing since for a long, long time. Long time ago, first quarter, I think we learned how to do this, and that's divide the sentence between the subject part of the sentence and the predicate part of the sentence. So let's read this first sentence. It says, Jenna spent a quarter for a bookmark. Raise your hand if you can tell me where to divide that sentence. Yes, please.
Jenna.
After Jenna. All right, so the subject part of the sentence is Jenna, and the predicate part is spent a quarter for a bookmark. So if you look at the predicate part of the sentence, what is the action verb?
Spent.
That's what she did. All right? Then you say, who did it? Who did it? Everybody.
Jenna.
So that is the subject. Okay? We used to underline the subject part of the sentence one time, and the predicate part of the sentence two times. Well, now we're going to get more specific, and we're underlining the verb and the subject itself. This is the actual subject, because sometimes they include other parts in the sentence that aren't the actual subject. Like in that sentence, it says, our dog splashed in the pond. Georgia, where are we going to divide that one?
After dogs.
Okay, we divide after dogs. And then you look at the predicate part of the sentence, splashed in the pond, face, what's the verb?
Splashed.
And if you say to yourself, who splashed? The answer is
dogs.
So you're just underlining dogs, not our dogs. It doesn't matter whose dogs they are. My dogs, your dogs, his dogs, her dogs, their dogs. It doesn't matter. Dogs is the subject of your sentence. Dogs splashed. Okay? And that is what you'll have to do on the test next, not next week, but the week after, at the beginning of the week. Okay? So, now, subject verb agreement. Let's look at our paper so we can read the rule on the paper. Everybody look at the top of your paper? It says, a verb that ends in S or ES tells what one person or thing does. Do not add S or ES to the verb if the sentence tells about more than one. All right, so let's look at this first verb that we're using right here. This verb is seen. All right? So what you have to remember here is it's sort of opposite. When we were talking about nouns, we knew that if we were trying to make it plural, then we'd usually add S or ES, right?
Yeah.
Well, when it is plural for the subject, for the verb, you do not want to add S or ES. You sort of do the opposite because you don't want to have too many S's or ES's going on. It's hard to say and it doesn't make sense, okay? So when it's singular for the subject, then you want to add S or ES to the verb. When it is plural for the subject, then you don't want to add S or ES to the verb, okay? So you're sort of doing the opposite of what you think of. So let's look at the first one. Bella sing or sings, right? Is Bella singular or plural? Joey?
Singular.
Singular. Bella is the name of one girl. So that means it tells us to do what? Add S or ES. So which one are we going to pick?
Sings.
And you guys are bubbling in. I was trying to remember what they want you to do whenever you have to do it. They're having you underline it. So I'm going to underline it. They have you underline it twice. Not today, but in the future, they have you underline it twice. Okay, so I'm going to underline it twice. So Bella is your subject, sings. All right, now let's do the next one. This one says children. Is children singular or plural?
Plural.
So this time you choose the one that does not have an S. So we're going to say children.
Sings.
Who just said sings?
I accidentally.
Okay. You understand? You pick the one without the S?
Yes.
All right. You do sort of the opposite. You're thinking opposite of what you normally would do. The noun gets the S that's plural, but the verb does not. All right. Then we have Elijah, and this time our verse is help. Help or helps. All right. So Elijah is what, Dane? Singular or plural?
Singular.
Because Elijah. Elijah's name of one person. One person. So Elijah, since it's singular, the verb needs to
add
S. Add the S. Very good. So we're going to say Elijah
helps.
Very good. Boys. Boys is what, Allison?
Plural.
So then we go to the verb and we're going to do what?
Boys help.
Take away the S. So we're going to say boys help. Very good. You guys understand why? Because otherwise you'd be saying boys help. Does that even sound right?
No.
It's really hard to say, isn't it?
Boys
help. No. So you do the opposite and you take away that S. On this one you didn't, but you still choose the one without the S because that's plural. Even though children doesn't have an S, you still do the opposite and use the one without the S. All right, let's look at the paper. We're going to do that on your paper. So the first sentence is about Annie. So Annie is?
A girl.
Okay, but I need to know singular plural.
Singular.
Singular. So we're going to pick the one that has S or no S?
S.
S. S. So which one do we put? Annie?
Studies.
Studies. You need to bubble in the sentences as Annie studies. Since Annie is singular, you need to pick the verb that has the S, studies. Are you with me? You've already answered it? If you haven't answered it yet, you're not with me. Number two, the subject is what?
Students.
Students. So students is?
Plural.
So we need to pick the verb that has?
Singular.
No, you need to say S or no S?
No S.
No, no S. S. And so you're going to pick students?
Sit. In these desks.
Students sit. Yeah, you guys can read the whole sentence in your mind. I'm going to focus on the subject and the verb only. So that you guys can focus on the subject and the verb as you're learning it. Okay, does that make sense?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, number three, Grant. Grant is singular or plural?
Singular.
Singular. Is Chase the only one supposed to be answering? Come on, guys, wake up out there.
I thought you were talking to Grant.
Yeah.
No, it's just, I didn't make the sentence off the book today.
Uh-oh.
So Grant is singular, so we need to pick the verb that has...
No S. I mean, yes.
S.
And S.
S. You have to pick the one with the S. So you're going to pick Grant.
Grant smiles.
That is wrong. Grant smiles. The one with the S. Grant is singular, so you pick smiles. All right, the next one says, one moose paw in the snow. Or one moose paws in the snow. So one moose means moose was what?
Singular.
Singular. So you need to pick the verb that has a
S.
And they said one, so you would know that moose was singular because moose can also be plural, can't it? But one moose paws in the snow. Oxen. Oxen. Oxen is what?
Singular.
Oh, no.
Plural.
What is the singular of oxen?
Ox.
Ox is singular. Oxen is plural. So you need to pick the verb that has?
No S.
No S. So you say oxen
pull.
All right. Now we're going to do what we were doing on the board right here for the next section. So I'll read the directions with you. Or the section, it says, first find the verb, then ask who or what. Who or what did that? So in other words, right here, spent. Who spent? Jenna spent. Splashed. Who splashed? Dog splashed. Okay? So first find the verb and then ask who did it. And that's the best way to find the subject of the sentence. All right? And you're supposed to draw a line to separate the subject and the predicate parts of the sentence first. And then we're going to draw two lines under the action verb because that's what you're supposed to find first. Then ask yourself who did it and underline that once because that's your subject. Okay? We're going to go around the room. Okay? So we're going to start with the sentence. Read the sentence with me.
New Mexico shares borders with Texas, Oklahoma, Colorado, Arizona, and Mexico.
Which most of those are states, but Mexico is another country. Where are we going to divide it?
After Chase. New Mexico.
Yes, after the beginning, New Mexico. Draw the line to divide it. Looking at the predicate part of the sentence, borders with Texas, Oklahoma, Colorado, Arizona, and Mexico. Who knows what the verb is? Joey?
Shares?
I don't see the word shares in that. Oh, I'm sorry. I said didn't read that, did I? Yes, it is shares. I'm sorry. I skipped that word when I read it the second time, didn't I?
Yes.
New Mexico
Mexico shares borders. Borders can also be a verb. You could say New Mexico borders Texas, Oklahoma. But I read it wrong. It shares borders. So yes, shares is a verb. Then you ask yourself the question, who shares? So who shares?
Mexico.
New Mexico. So shares should be underlined how many times?
Twice.
Twice. New Mexico should be underlined how many times?
Once.
Okay, so we understand that? So shares is the verb and New Mexico. And I'm sorry for reading that sentence wrong. But borders, in this case, it's a noun because it says shares borders. But if you were to write this sentence, New Mexico borders Texas without the word with, then borders would be a verb. Does everybody understand that?
Yes.
But it is shares this time. Borders is a noun in this sentence. All right, let's read the next one. Tourists enjoy the Four Corners National Monument. All right? So where are we going to divide that one? Chloe?
After tourists.
After tourists. Very good. So then you look at the predicate part of the sentence, and you have to tell me what is the verb. You already answered. Put your hand up.
Enjoy.
Enjoy is the verb. So then you ask yourself, who enjoy? Riley?
Tourists.
So how many times did you underline enjoy?
Twice.
Two times. How many times did you underline tourists?
Once.
Very good. So tourist, enjoy. Tourist is a subject. Enjoy is the verb. Let's read the next one. By the way, how many of you remember me telling you about the place, Four Corners, where you can stand in one spot and you're standing in four different states all at once because they all meet together? And when we learn this, the West, that's when we'll see those states. All right, read the next one. Visitors stand. Oh, I skipped one. Let's read the one above that. Arizona, Colorado, Utah, and New Mexico meet at the Four Corners. All right, so where are we going to divide that one? Leanna? All right, so you could have just said right after New Mexico. You could just tell me that last one. After New Mexico, draw that line to divide it. Divide it after the word New Mexico. We have a long subject part of the sentence this time, don't we?
Yes.
So looking at the predicate part of the sentence, somebody who hasn't answered yet for this section, tell me what's the verb?
Meet.
All right, this is not talking about the meat you eat. This is talking about when you come together. Coming together, like a group of friends, meet at the mall to have a day of shopping. Meet. Okay? So underline meet how many times?
Twice.
Two times. All right, now the tricky part. Who hasn't done one? Grant, you haven't done one yet? Grant, can you tell me who meet?
Arizona, Colorado, Utah, and New Mexico.
Okay, so you're going to have to underline every one of those one time, except don't underline the word and. And is not part of the subject. It is the connecting word, joining those four states together. All right? It's called a conjunction. We already talked about it when we put two run-on sentences together. We talked about a conjunction. We talked about it a little bit when we were doing words in a series. Right? But it is not the subject. It is just a joining word to add that last. This is a words in a series, but all of them are the subject. Okay, because sometimes the subject can be more than one thing, right? Because that's four different states that meet in that one place. All right, let's read the next one. Number four, visitors stand in all four states at one time. Somebody who hasn't done it yet. Someone, Georgia.
After visitors,
divided after visitors. Look at the predicate side of the sentence. What is the action verb? Who hasn't done one now?
Yeah, Grayson.
Stand.
Very good. The action there is stand. So underline stand how many times?
Twice.
Is there anyone else that hasn't done one?
Allison.
Allison? Who stand?
Visitors.
There's only one word to choose because you divided it right after visitors. So there's pretty obvious that visitors are the ones that stand. Visitors stand. So visitors gets underlined.
Once.
Visitors gets underlined.
Once.
Thank you. Guys, when you're dividing it after only one word, it's pretty obvious what the subject is. It's when you've got a group of words and you divide it at the end that you have to figure out what the subject is by asking yourself, who did the action, okay? Or what did the action? All right, let's read the next one. Like this next one. Each year people visit the Albuquerque International Balloon Festival. Has everyone done one now?
Uh-huh.
No, Elise. Elise hasn't. Elise, we're going to divide that one. Yes, after the word people. Because it says each year people, well, the year didn't do anything, did it? It's the people that are doing something. So looking at the predicate side of the sentence, has everyone done one now?
Yes.
All right, then, Brantley, what's the verb?
Visit.
Visit. So visit gets underlined how many times?
Twice.
Twice. The action there is visit. Who visit? Chase?
People.
People. People visit. So people is your subject. Underline people?
Once.
Once. One more. Many hot air balloons fly over the city. All right. Allison, we're going to divide it.
After balloons.
This is one of those that I was talking about. Many hot air balloons fly over the city. Divide after balloons. What's your verb if you look at the predicate part of the sentence, Chloe?
Fly.
Fly. Underline fly how many times?
Twice.
Twice. And this is just the tiniest bit tricky, but it's, who can tell me what fly? Dane?
A hot air balloon.
All right, that's what's tricky about it. You don't need that much. You just need
balloons.
You just need balloons. There's different kinds of balloons, right? There's party balloons and there are hot air balloons. Hot air would be an adjective describing what kind of balloon it is. There's weather balloons, which are similar to hot air balloons, but it's just a balloon going up with instruments to measure things about the weather, right? So there's different kinds of balloons. So you don't want the adjective that's describing what kind of balloon it is. You just want balloons. Underline balloons twice. And that's the last one. Put that paper in your classwork folder for tomorrow.